we shall reflect on the life of St. Lawrence O'Toole of Dublin. St. Lawrence was only 10 when he was delivered up as a hostage by his own father to the King of Leinster. The King treated him rather inhumanly for 2 years before putting him in the hands of the Bishop of Glendinlough in the county of Wicklow. The holy youth, by his fidelity in corresponding with the divine grace, grew to be a model of virtue. On the death of the bishop, who was also abbot of the monastery, Lawrence, though not yet 25, was chosen abbot. His diocese was at that time a wealthy one, but the holy prelate reduced himself to poverty in order to bestow all he possessed on the poor. He governed his community with wonderful virtue and prudence, and frequently gave himself to spiritual retreats so as to be the more efficient in the reformation of his flock. In the year 1161, the saint was unanimously chosen to fill the new metropolitan see of Dublin. About the year 1171, he was obliged for the affairs of his diocese to go over to England to see King Henry II, who was then at Canterbury. He was received by the Benedictine monks of Christ Church with the greatest honor and respect. The following day, as he approached the altar to officiate at Mass, a maniac who had heard much of his sanctity and perhaps led on by the idea of making so holy a man another Saint Thomas, struck him violently on the head. Obviously, Lawrence was mortally wounded, but the holy archbishop, coming to himself, asked for some water and blessed it. Then, even as he washed his wounds with it, the flow of blood stopped and he celebrated Mass. In 1175, Lawrence undertook another journey to England to negotiate reconciliation between the two monarchs, Henry II and Roderick of Ireland. So moved was the English king by his piety, charity, and prudence that he granted him everything he asked for and left the entire negotiation process to his discretion. His earthly journey having ended on the 14th of November, 1180, Lawrence was buried in the church of the Abbey at Eu, within the confines of Normandy, and was canonized by Pope Honorius III in 1225.